Hi and welcome to this edition of Out the Box. My name is Paul. Today we're going to have a look at what is in this box. This is the UniFi Access G2 Starter Kit Professional. This is part of the UniFi Access range. This is about door control security for your building. The idea being you're going to have what's called a hub, which we'll show in a minute, per door. You're going to have a reader on the inside or the outside, or a release button on the inside and a different reader on the outside. And you can use swipe cards, you can use key fobs, you can use mobile devices to allow authorization of that door being opened, or a number of doors that are connected together. There is the standard Generation 2 G2 starter kit, which is slightly different. This comes with the key fobs. The other one comes with the door access cards. So quite a few components. So I'm going to try and just wander you through. There's not big technical overview, but hopefully should give you some ideas of what is in the box. So as I reach over to start with, you are going to get your little get started guide. All right. And on the back, it's going to show you your three main components, which is your hub, your reader, and your Gen 2 Reader Pro. All right. So let's start working through. Let's maybe talk about the guts of this to start with, which is the hub. All right, this is the hub. This is really about your 12 volt wiring. This is PoE powered. It needs 802.3bt, so PoE++. The idea here is your PoE is going to come in from maybe your Pro Ubiquiti switch. All right, you have options here for your readers to be plugged in, which we'll have a look at in a moment. And then you have options if you want to add in a camera or something like that, that can have some level of extra features or alerting, or even just being used for monitoring. So you can think of some of that, if you like, as a little bit more like a network switch, but it all is related to this hub. Then obviously we have all of our different wiring terminals on these sides. This is going out to your doors, your strikes, your options for door release. So obviously one of these will go to a release bar or a button that you have inside. So as somebody approaches the door for exit, they push it and it releases it. Your readers, like we talked about, will go out here, which we'll talk about in a moment. And those are the ones that allow your swipe cards, your mobile phone to access it, or the key fobs. So this is the heart. You need one of these per physical door. It is possible to open multiple doors with one of these. There's various videos around on the internet that allows you or shows you how to do it. But the idea being that if the card is swiped for this unit, it will also unlock all doors that are physically connected to this. So as long as you've got two or three doors that you don't mind unlocking at the same time, then you could use one unit. But generally, you're going to use one of these per door. So like I said, not really much more I can show you other than the wiring terminals on this side and obviously your PoE in and your other network ports across the side. On the back here, it's, if you like, a bit more like a DIN rail mount. So you get a rail here. This is going to go in a box somewhere probably, or in a recess by the door. The idea that this gets pushed up under there, all right, and pushed up into place. And obviously if that's screwed into place, now your unit is held there. So that is the hub. With that, you will get some screws and lugs to be able to mount the hub. Hadn't shown you, you also get a little conformity guide there with the whole setup. So let's now move on to probably the readers. So this is the Gen 2 reader, the standard model. We'll look at the Pro that comes in the box as well. All right, so again, this is for your fobs or for your cards to be put against this. So this is going on the outside of your property. So let me just reach over and find all of the other components together that makes this work, because there are quite a few bits that need to be put together to make it happen. So let me just find everything that is needed, and then I can walk you through each piece so you can see what's happening. So there's just a little box here that actually has the faceplates for this device. So let's walk this through from the beginning. So you are going to get a little drilling guide, all right, for where the holes need to go. It is designed to be put into a recess. Oh, almost dropped that. All right, so this is your recess hole. This is going to be dug out of your wall, or obviously going to go into your gyprock hollow wall or something if you've got like that. Just show you the front. All right, and your unit is designed, the reader is designed to clip into this. So you bring it into place and you can clip it. There is a quick release tool that we can then use to actually release this from the connection, which is in one of the packets we'll get to in a moment. And then on the bottom here, we also have our small light so that as people come closer, it will shine some light down. On the back, we have our RJ45 connection, which is obviously, this is going to be powered by your hub. So you're going to have a cable from this to your hub. All right. And once you've got your cable in place, you can feed it through this bung. And the bung is then going to fit, if I've got this the right bung, nope, this is the square one. All right, you're going to furrow it through this one, and then that is going to fit into place like that to give you a seal. So we have this, and that's going to clip into here. We then have our plates around it. So you get another drilling guide for the plates, because you could flush mount that if you just wanted to mount that like that. But you probably want to finish it off slightly neater. So you're getting a full plate that can be fitted then to the wall. And then obviously the idea here is that the rest of your setup can be clamped and screwed through there into place like that. Hopefully you can see that. All right. And then obviously I've not all clipped it all into place. And then you can take your overarching cover. Probably your overarching cover should be able to go on there because I've just got some pieces of the plastic still left on there. All right, and then everything will be neatly flush mounted in place. So that's your G2 reader. You get a packet of lugs and screws with that. Let me just check. Yep, here's your packet of screws and lugs. In here, in this packet, in one of the other ones here, you're going to get your little quick release tool. There it is. So here's your other screws and your quick release tool. This is allow you to obviously disconnect this, because we don't want that to be able to be easily removed by people. You've got your quick release hole on this side, which you're going to push into and allow you to disconnect it. So that is the G2 reader. Then we repeat the similar process with the G2 reader Pro. So obviously you may have one of these inside if you wanted to do card release in and out, or you may use this for another location at a different door or a different entrance point to unlock the same doors. We are then going to get the G2 Reader Pro. This is much more like the G4 doorbell. We've got a light again at the bottom here. We've got a full LCD panel. We've got our camera up the top here. So now we can actually see the person that has come up to the door. We have the same options here in the back, obviously our Ethernet port in. We're going to run our cable and mount in a similar way. So let me just show you that. You're going to get another packet of screws and lugs for that one. And again, another set of quick release tool and lugs. Then we get obviously all of our same as we did for the previous one. So we are going to get our drilling guide and level, which obviously then allows us to mount this plate in place, which is a similar than what we've seen before, allows this to clip into place like this. All right, and we can use our quick release tool on this to be able to disconnect it as well as needed. But then obviously we have the ability to flush mount that as well. So we are going to get our full backing plate. Hopefully that's useful to see that. So that backing plate's going to go on the wall. Obviously then our insert probably is, let me just have a look, probably isn't needed in this instance. So now this can be fitted into place onto there. And then obviously we can have our final plate that's going to go over the top and clip into place and make that neat and tidy. You do get a full drilling guide for that as well. All right, so that is probably, this is, like I said, much more like a two-way proper intercom system with talkback. This will support, I think, mobile phone NFCs against it. You've got swipe cards and you've got key fobs. So you've got quite a lot of options with this as a door entry system. We do have that bung as well. Here, So we're going to run our Ethernet cable through, then we're going to push that into place. All right, and that's going to keep out the dust and dirt when that's sitting in the recess of the wall. So that is most of the devices. And then in this instance, in this pack, we also get two key fobs. So we don't get the access cards, which you get in the standard starter kit. You get these two key fobs. All right, again, the key fobs can be are programmed up against one of these. UniFi Access needs to be run on an OS console, a Ubiquiti OS console. What's that? That's the UDR. That's the Dream Machine Pro, the Dream Machine SE, or the Cloud Key Generation 2 Plus. And it also runs on the UNVR as an option, and the UNVR Pro as well. So your key fobs obviously can be programmed, added to somebody's key ring. They can come to one of the readers here, touch your swipe against the reader, and that's obviously going to do the function that you want, unlock the door if they have permission. Wow, there are a lot of items in there. Hopefully that does help you, give you an idea of all the items that make this up. Obviously the hub is your key. You need one of those per door. Then you have the G2 reader, the standard one here. And then you've got the option for the G2 Pro, which is much more like a doorbell option with camera and full LCD screen as well. And obviously you get your key fobs in there and all the mounting brackets and everything that goes with it. Hopefully that's been useful to show you what is in the Ubiquiti UniFi Access G2 Starter Kit Professional. Head on over to our YouTube channel. We've got plenty more box openings on wireless networking devices. What do I need to run UniFi Network or UniFi Protect or UniFi Access? So hopefully you find those videos. So head on over there, subscribe, and stay up to date.